Hello family, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video we are making some yummy lime potato chips and some guacamole that you've seen on my thumbnail and in the beginning of the video. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos and turn on your notification bell so you don't miss each and every time I post a new video. But for now, let's get to today's video. So guys, for today's video, these are the potatoes that I'm going to be working with. I'm just going to peel my potatoes, all my potatoes. I don't know the exact number that I used, but I hope you can see them. I'm sorry. So all I'm going to do is to peel my potatoes well, as shown in the video. So I'll leave you to watch that for a while and I'll be right back. So guys, I turned off my camera for a little while and finished peeling all my potatoes. I'm just going to discard the outer part that we peeled later. Right now all I'm going to do is to wash my potatoes. I'm sorry. So guys, as you can see right now, I'm just removing the black spots that always remain on potatoes. I don't really like them, so I always remove them. So I'm just going to remove them on all my potatoes as shown in the video. So I'll leave you to watch that for a little while and I'll be right back. So guys, moving on, and now just as you can see, all our potatoes are really smooth now and they are looking really good. All I'm going to do is just to rewash them with some clean water. And then moving on, I'm now just going to lay some potatoes on my chopping board that I have right there. And then all I'm going to do is to slice my potatoes, to thinly slice. I'm just going to thinly slice my potatoes. The raw potato chips have to be thinly sliced, guys. So guys, these are homemade potato chips. Some of them will be small and then some of them will be large. So guys, you don't have to worry about that. That is just the beauty of potato chips. So all I'm going to do is just to slice them. Just take your time to slice your potato chips, and you have to be careful with your knife too. So guys, as you can see right now, I'm just showing you the sizes that I use. As you can see, they are thinly sliced. So guys, I turned off my camera for a little while, and as you can see, I finished slicing my potato chips, and as you can see, I'm showing you clearly how they look there. They look really, really good. So I'm just going to set that aside. Moving on, I'm going to preheat my pan, and then I'm going to add some oil. And then all I'm going to do is to preheat my oil until it's super hot, as shown in the video. Thank you. Well guys, when my phone is already hot, I'm now just going to add my potato chips. I'm just going to add my potato chips on my pan as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to spread them evenly so that they can all answer it, so that they can all fry well as shown in the video. So guys, I used a little medium high flame for this so that my potato chips don't become soggy and don't absorb so much oil. We need our potato chips to be crispy. So I'll leave it to add that for a while and I'll be right back. Moving on guys, all I'm going to do is to flip all my potato chips over, I'm sorry, so that both sides can fry well. So guys, while doing this, you will see that some potato chips got stuck to each other. So as you can see right now, I'm just removing the potato chips that are ready right there. So the ones that are stuck to each other, they will take a little more time to fry well. So you can just leave them behind to fry well, and you have to make sure all your potato chips are really fried well. So guys, after removing all the potato chips that are ready, I'm now just going to repeat the process until all our potato chips that we prepared, that I shown you earlier on in the video. So I'm just going to repeat the process with all your potato chips. I'm going to fry both sides of them as shown in the video. So I'll leave it like that and I'll be right back. So guys, I'm back and I just finished frying my last batch of my potato chips. So as you can see right there, our potato chips are ready. So guys, as I said in the beginning of the video, some of the potato chips will be large and some will be small. That's just the beauty of homemade potato chips. Guys, moving on, I used a lemon. I'm sorry, first I'm going to set my potato chips aside, and then moving on, I used a lemon. I'm going to start making our guacamole. So I used a lemon for our guacamole. I'm just going to roll my lemon on my surface right there. I'm just going to roll it around as shown in the video to remove the juice from our lemon. You can replace the lemon with lime also works well, but I couldn't find lime, so I just used lemon. So after rolling my lemon, I'm just going to squeeze out the juice, and as you can see, I'm straining it so that we don't have the lemon seeds on our juice right there. So guys, as you can see, Alam Jesus ready, for I'm going to do is to put over a potato chips that you already fried. And then all I'm going to do is to give it a little mix right there. And then I'm going to add some black pepper to taste to give it a little heat. You have to bring that heat a little to it, guys. So you can use red pepper or black pepper, but Fabia used black pepper. And then I'm going to give it a little mix again. And then all I'm going to do is to sprinkle some salt on my chips, as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to mix my chips well, as shown in the video. So guys, the salt that I was holding was not working for me anymore, so I used my hand. Your hand is the best tool you can always use for this. It's the best tool that you have. So as you can see, I mixed it well and our chips are now ready. And my little boy is also ready to eat. He was eating the chips. I was even afraid he was going to finish all of them. I'm just going to set our chips aside because we are going to need them. Moving on, guys, as you can see, I'm holding two of my ripe avocados. And then I'm going to repeat the process that we did with the lemon. I'm just going to roll them to make them even more soft. And then all I'm going to do is to cut my avocado in half. So my avocado was ripe, but it was not so ripe for me. So I had to roll it around to make it even more riper. I don't know if that's a word. So after rolling it, as shown in the video, all I'm going to do is to scoop my avocado out. And as you can see, our is going off. We rolled it and it's now so easy to scoop out. I'm just going to scoop both my avocados out, as shown in the video. So I'll leave it to watch me for a little while and I'll be right back. So guys, moving on, after I'm done scooping my avocado out, I'm now just going to quickly mash my avocado. So for me, I just used a spoon for this because we rolled our avocados and it was already so soft. I'm now just adding my 1 medium size red onion. So guys, I was saying red onion. I'm sorry about that. My son seems to be talking a lot in the background. So I'm also going to add my 2 medium sized ripe tomatoes, chopped ripe tomatoes. And then all I'm going to do is to give my guacamole a quick mix after the video. So guys, you can replace the red onion with white onion. I think that will work too. So all I'm going to do is to really mix my guacamole, as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to add some black pepper to taste. I'm also going to add some salt to taste. I'm going to sprinkle some salt to taste, as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to give my guacamole a good mix again, as shown in the video. So guys, after making sure you mix your guacamole well, you have to taste your food, guys, to know if you need to adjust anything. So for me, I needed to adjust some salt. As you can see, I adjusted some salt. If you need to adjust black pepper, you can also adjust black pepper. So right now I'm just going to add my lots and lots of chopped cilantro, or coriander as you know it. And then all I'm going to do is to mix my guacamole again, as shown in the video. So guys, I'll leave it to have that for a little while and I'll be right back. So guys, after mixing our guacamole well, as you can see, our guacamole is ready, guys, and it looks really, really yummy. I love this recipe, guys. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below, and make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. And thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.